Moreover, the old woman grabbed up my severed head and carried it away with her and hid it. But Nimmie Amee came into the forest and found me wandering around helplessly, because I could not see where to go, and she led me to my friend the tinsmith. The faithful fellow at once set to work to make me a tin head, and he had just completed it when Nimmie Amee came running up with my old head, which she had stolen from the witch. But on reflection I considered the tin head far superior to the meat one. I am wearing it yet, so you can see its beauty and grace of outline, and the girl agreed with me that a man all made of tin was far more perfect than one formed of different materials. The tinsmith was as proud of his workmanship as I was, and for 3 whole days all admired me and praised my beauty. Being now completely formed of tin, I had no more fear of the wicked witch, for she was powerless to injure me. Nimmie Amee said we must be married at once, for then she could come to my cottage and live with me and keep me bright and sparkling. "I am sure, my dear Nick," said the brave and beautiful girl, my name was then Nick Chopper, you should be told, "that you will make the best husband any girl could have. I shall not be obliged to cook for you, for now you do not eat. I shall not have to make your bed, for tin does not tire or require sleep. When we go to a dance, you will not get weary before the music stops and say you want to go home. All day long, while you are chopping wood in the forest, I shall be able to amuse myself in my own way, a privilege few wives enjoy.